from shithole countries come here, the president said today at the White House. His comments, reported first by the Washington Post, confirmed by CNN, and amazingly not denied by the president or the people around him. Tired of Africans and Haitians, the president went on to say he would like to bring more people from countries like Norway. Norway, whose population is overwhelmingly of Nordic descent. White people, in other words. James Baldwin, the great writer, the great American, once said that, quote, ignorance allied with power is the most ferocious enemy justice can have. Ignorance allied with power. For the president of the United States to believe that Haitians have not contributed extraordinary things to American society, that is ignorant. For him to claim that all the countries of Africa are shitholes is woefully ignorant. But as disturbing as you may think these sentiments are, these comments by the president, they are actually not anything new. 3 weeks ago, the New York Times reported something else the president said about Haitians in another meeting at the White House. About Haitians, he reportedly said they, quote, all have AIDS, and said that Nigerians, quote, live in huts. Now, the White House denied he said those things at the time 3 weeks ago. They are not denying he said the comments today, which were spoken in a room with bipartisan lawmakers. Perhaps the White House feels the president's remarks will be well received in some parts of this country, among some parts of the president's base. And perhaps that is true. But it doesn't make what he said any less ignorant or any less racist. Not racial, not racially charged, racist. Let's not kid ourselves. Let's not pretend or dance around it. The sentiment the president expressed today is a racist sentiment. But there was another surprising moment at the White House today. Stop me if you heard that one before. The whole dust-up was over a series of contradictory tweets sent by the president. They came as the House was set to vote on a reauthorization of the Foreign Intelligence Surveillance Act, otherwise known as FISA, specifically an extension of Section 702, which in part allows the intelligence community to monitor foreign communications. It's been credited with stopping terror plots. Critics say it allows warrantless surveillance. At 7:33 this morning, the president took issue with FISA, writing on Twitter, quote, House votes on controversial FISA Act today. This is the act that may have been used with the help of the discredited and phony dossier to so badly surveil and abuse the Trump campaign by the previous administration and others, oddly placed question mark. And that led to confusion on Capitol Hill. Lawmakers said so themselves, including some Republicans. And the confusion was well-founded because the administration had less than 12 hours before the president's tweet sent out a statement in support of the FISA reauthorization. So for almost 2 hours, no one could figure out where exactly the White House actually stood until the president went back on the Twitter machine and reversed course back to support for FISA with this post at 9:14 a.m. With that being said, I have personally directed the fix to unmasking process since taking office, and today's vote is about foreign surveillance of foreign bad guys on foreign land. We need it. Get smart. The vote then took place. It passed this afternoon. Asked about the confusion and contradictory tweets, White House Press Secretary Sarah Sanders repeatedly insisted, of course, there was no confusion.
We don't think that there was a conflict at all. We don't see any contradiction or confusion in that. We weren't confused, but some of you guys were. President's been clear about what his position is. I'm not sure what the confusion is there.
Yep, no confusion at all. It must be us. Now, I just want to take a moment to talk about Haiti, one of the places the president of the United States referred to today as a shithole country. I was taught math in high school by a Haitian immigrant named Yves Volel, who worked hard, who dedicated himself to teaching kids in America. He ultimately returned to his country of Haiti and was assassinated while running for president. I spent a lot of time in Haiti. I first went there in the early 1990s as a young reporter. In 2010, my team from CNN was the first international team of journalists on the ground after the earthquake struck. I spent more than a month there and have returned many times on assignment and on vacation. Like all countries, Haiti is a collection of people. It's rich and poor, well-educated and not, good and bad. But I've never met a Haitian who isn't strong. You have to be to survive in a place where the government has often abandoned its people, where opportunities are few, and where Mother Nature has punished the people far more than anyone should ever be punished. But let me be clear tonight. The people of Haiti have been through more. They've been through more. They withstood more. They fought back against more injustice than our president ever has. Tomorrow marks exactly 8 years since the earthquake struck Haiti. A 7.1 magnitude earthquake killed anywhere between 220,000 and 300,000 people. The actual numbers will never be known because they were buried in unmarked pits. 1.5 million people were displaced. For days and weeks, without help from their own government or police, the people of Haiti dug through rubble with their bare and bloodied hands to save complete strangers, guided only by the cries of the wounded and the dying. I was there when a young girl named Bee, who'd been trapped in rubble for nearly a day, was rescued by people who had no heavy equipment. They just had their God-given strength and their determination and their courage. I was there when a 5-year-old boy named Monley was rescued after being buried for more than 7 days. Do you know what strength it takes to survive on rainwater buried under concrete, a 5-year-old boy buried for 7 days? Haitians slap your hand hard when they shake it. They look you in the eye. They don't blink. They stand tall and they have dignity. It's a dignity many in this White House could learn from. It's a dignity the president, with all his money and all his power, could learn from as well. On the anniversary of the earthquake, on this day when this president has said what he has said about Haitians, we hope the people in Haiti who are listening tonight in Port-au-Prince and Jacmel and Benet and Miami and elsewhere, we hope they know that our thoughts are with them and that our love is with them as well. Joining me, Van Jones, Bakari Sellers, Jason Miller, Anna Navarro, and Mark Lauder. Anna, I mean, in your opinion, is there any other way to interpret this comment other than being just racist?
Of course there's no other way to interpret it. This is not an isolated comment. The first thing he did when he started running was call Mexicans rapists. He has gone on to equate white supremacists in Charlottesville to the people protesting against them. He has called black athletes sons of bitches. He has feuded with the congresswoman who represents Little Haiti, Frederica Wilson. Last year at this time, he was feuding with civil rights icon John Lewis. This is not a coincidence. This is a pattern of behavior. We have a racist, a shameless racist who has hijacked the Republican Party, who has hijacked the Oval Office. And this country needs to stand up against this and tell him that we will not let him divide us by color, by race, by ethnicity, by class, by economy. We will not be quiet. We will not allow this. Donald Trump, this is not America. This is not America. And we will fight against your division, your racism, your anger, your hatred, and all the horrible things you are trying to do to this country.
Van Jones, should this come as a surprise to people?
Well, I mean, it's not only racist, it's also just inaccurate. I mean, I just want numbers sometimes matter. 33% of Americans have college degrees. God bless everybody. It's a lot of hard work. Now we've got student debt. 43% of African immigrants have college degrees, okay? 11% of white people in America have a graduate degree. One quarter, 25% of Nigerian Americans have a graduate degree. So what is he talking about? Part of the thing is that when you're relying on just horrible stereotypes, by the way, Melania Trump, our first lady, who I admire greatly, is from Slovenia, not exactly the jewel of Europe, Slovenia. But she's welcome here and Nigerians are not. There's something wrong with the way this president is proceeding. I don't think anybody here on this panel can defend these kind of comments. If you want to have a conversation about immigration policy, you can have it without insulting whole continents and whole countries, especially when you have African immigrants coming to this country, making America better every day and being disrespected by this president.
Jason, I mean, the idea that all Haitians have AIDS, that they should get out, that the president doesn't want more black people from Africa or from Haiti, wants more white people from Norway, is that defensible?
So, Anderson, that's not at all what the president said. And so let's talk about the context of what today was.
He didn't say that all Haitians have AIDS?
No.
According to the New York Times.
Well, Anderson, the White House has denied that.
Right, they denied that when it was a meeting of White House staff, but when it's a group of bipartisan lawmakers today, they can't deny it because bipartisan lawmakers heard it. So, it's such a big jump for him to say all Haitians have AIDS to him saying
Anderson, I don't think the point here is for you or me or anyone else on this panel to put words into the president's mouth.
We don't need to put words in the president's mouth. The president is putting racist words in his own mouth.
Go ahead. He was not making racist comments. So today, the whole point of the meeting is the fact that President Trump, unlike Democrats and Republicans in the past, is actually going to get something done on Dreamers, something that I don't think he's getting any credit for.
Okay, we're talking about Haitians and black people from Africa.
But hold on. So this is the meeting, having a meeting, a bipartisan meeting, talk about what we're going to do about the 700,000 or 800,000 Dreamers who are here. They get to the section on overall comprehensive immigration reform. Again, something that Obama couldn't get done, Bush couldn't get done, but Trump's going to get it done. So they get to the section on merit-based immigration. And the president has been very clear that he doesn't think there should be carve-outs from any country, not from Norway, not from Great Britain, not from Haiti, not from El Salvador, not from any country does he think there should be special carve-outs by each country. He thinks it should be merit-based by each person. And that's something that Canada does.
What does that have to do with talking about S-hole?
Because, hold on. Because, so he very specifically.
So there's more people with merit from Norway than there are from Haiti and from Africa.
The point
Africa, by the way, an enormous continent full of dozens of countries.
It should be by the individual. It shouldn't be carve-outs. The plan that these lawmakers came back to them actually still had these carve-outs for countries that are on the TPS list, countries that are in severely economically distressed places that are sending us tens of thousands of people
Africa.
Who have literally, if they even have the shirts
Africa.
On their backs, then
have,
they're
Have you
then
been
lucky.
To Africa? Do you know how many countries are in Africa? Does the president know? I know the president likes to make up countries that are not actually in Africa and that don't actually exist. But there are actually incredibly developed and well-off countries in Africa. In fact, the president was speaking to black African leaders, he was talking about all his rich friends who are making so much money in Africa.
Anderson, respectfully speaking, you're leaving a lot out for the conversation because what, as you even heard from Jim Acosta and we've heard from previous blocks, not only did the president say when he was thrown out of their country and he's talking about countries that are doing much better economically, he said Norway or countries in Asia. He didn't go and name specific countries in Asia. So he's talking around the world, but he's like, why would you go and specifically say that there need to be carve-outs from countries that are so economically distressed.
Right, so he's willing to generalize about all Asians as being people who are working hard and deserve the merit of coming here, but all Africans are not. How is that not something by race?
He's making the point that it should be by individuals and it shouldn't be going and targeting.
So everybody in Asia is hardworking and deserves to come here.
No, and Anderson, that's not what the president said. It should be, the whole point is it should be on merit-based system, just like the way that Canada does it on a points-based system. It's a pretty smart, comprehensive immigration idea. I think ultimately the president's going to get it done. And this is getting twisted around.
Van, I want you to respond to that.
This is not, I mean, you're trying to make it sound like... Go ahead, Bam.
No matter what, listen, I give you an A for effort, but the reality is you haven't addressed the issue that has alarmed the entire world. When you say S-hole countries, and then you say Norway is welcome and these people are not, that is not a smart conversation about immigration policy. You and I can disagree and argue about skills-based versus TPS versus anything else, but that's not what's happening.
And
what's
Van, there was salty language. Hold
on a second.
You got
your chance. And that's not what's happening. What's happening is you have a president that has shown his heart to the country. He showed his heart. And in his heart, people from Africa, people from Africa, almost a billion people live in Africa. To him, they all are S-hole people who live in S-hole places. That
you know
is
what?
Wrong,
Van,
and you should denounce it.
Remain,
and by the way, sir, and Jason, I know you very well. You should denounce it. You should
Van,
denounce that, Jason. I know you very
country,
well. And why won't you denounce that? Why won't you
world,
denounce S-hole nation?
Everyone in the world wants to come to the U.S.
You why won't why? You denounce
because
it?
Because this is a great place. If we're going
to
remain
you
the
think
shining
Africa
city
is an
on the
S-hole continent?
We have to reform.
Jason.
We have to reform.
Maybe we do.
I think that the president
Jason,
is absolutely
I'm talking
right
to man to man.
That,
I'm talking to you person
you know
to
what?
Person.
And don't try to bait me here, Van. I'm giving you a straight
Africa
answer that we
is
need
an S-hole continent. Yes or no?
You know what? There are a lot of S-hole places all around the world.
Do you think Africa is an S-hole continent?
Van,
do you think Haiti is an S-hole continent?
Effort to try to bait me because on the
is
left,
your president
you've run
said
out
it,
of
me?
Ideas. You've run out of ideas, and
no,
so you're
I've,
trying to bait me
you
on
want,
something.
You
to
want to have a conversation about immigration policy?
Okay, let me bring in Bakari Sellers.
Let me just say this.
Nobody can hear when we're all talking. Bakari, we haven't heard from you. When Jason is saying, you know, that there's a lot of shithole country. I mean, why don't we let's just use the word the president is using. If it's good enough for the president of the United States to use it, I think the American people deserve to hear what words the president is using. The idea that all countries in Africa are shitholes is just woefully ignorant. It's just, I mean, it's just moronic,
but I mean,
and it shows the president knows nothing.
Yeah, but I think that, I mean, I have to give Jason the name of my chiropractor for getting in that pretzel to defend this nonsense. I mean, the comments that the president made were asinine, they were ignorant, any other adjective you want to add to this discussion. But why are we surprised? I mean, why is this breaking news? I mean, if we go back in history, this is the same man who was sued by the Department of Justice and used to put a little C on black people's applications for color. Why are we surprised? This is the same person who was sued by African-American and minority dealers in his casino. Why are we surprised? This is the same man who still has not apologized for the Central Park Five. I mean, down here in South Carolina, we look out and throw our hands up to black folk and say, we have tried to tell you this is who this man was. It's not as if he is just showing you his heart today. Stokely Carmichael once said, a white man who wants to lynch me, that is his problem. A white man who has the power to lynch me, that is my problem. Racism is a question of power, not a question of attitude. And so when we say that the president of the United States is racist, it's because he harbors these views and he has the power to implement policy which subjugate these people to oppressive systems. I mean, this is not rocket science, and I'm not surprised at all. And I'm actually more surprised, and this is what drives me up a wall, Anderson. This is the problem with the discussion that we're having. People want to say, oh my God, he's talking to economic anxiety voters, or he's giving red meat to his base. The hell with all of that. I am sick and tired of the good people in this country who support Donald Trump, who will not stand up and call this for what it is. We have an issue with race in this country that dates long back before Donald Trump and long back before Barack Obama and George Bush and Bill Clinton and George Bush. But we have never dealt with that issue because good people sit on their hands. Yeah. If you cannot sit here on live TV and say that what the president of the United States, be his friend or not his friend, said was racist, then you are not contributing to breaking this a more perfect union. This is the frustrating part of this whole thing.